rural cancer survivors aren't as healthy as those who live in the city, according to a new research from Wake Forest Baptist Medical Center. And Dr. Kathryn Weaver joins us to explain why. Good to see you. Thank you for being here.
You're welcome.
All right. So how unhealthy, then, are the cancer survivors who live in rural areas compared to those who live in the city?
Well, in our recent study of almost 8,000 adult cancer survivors, we found that rural cancer survivors were more likely. Almost 36% of them said that they were in poor health after their cancer diagnosis. And they were also more likely to report that they couldn't work because of their health. So we were concerned about this, and these rates were both higher than those that were found among the survivors who lived in more urban areas.
What did you find about the contributing factors?
Well, specifically in this paper, we were interested in exploring the role of health behaviors. How might things like smoking and physical activity play a role? And we did find that rural cancer survivors were more likely to be current smokers. Almost 25% of them were smoking after their cancer diagnosis. And they were also more likely to be physically inactive, more than half saying that they got no physical activity. So, and these did seem to play a role in poor health.
Mm-hmm. So now, how significant are these findings in your estimation?
Well, I think the differences between rural and urban were large and significant. And these health behaviors are very important for cancer survivors. We know certainly smoking after a cancer diagnosis has all sorts of adverse, can lead to all sorts of adverse outcomes, including the cancer coming back or worse response to treatment, and even getting a second cancer after you've already been treated successfully for your first cancer. So we're very concerned about things like smoking and poor physical activity after cancer.
And so what can change these trends, you think?
Well, I think that healthcare professionals need to be aware of these broad patterns, and perhaps when they're working with rural cancer survivors, being aware of this and helping them to come up with a plan to improve their health behaviors after cancer. We're advocating that that as part of an overall wellness plan, survivors develop a plan to increase their physical activity. But living in a rural area might make that challenging, so we need to be aware of the availability of fitness facilities and perhaps think about in-home exercise programs that rural survivors could take advantage of.
All right, have to make that the last word. Dr. Kathryn Weaver, thank you so much. We appreciate your being here.
Thank you.